Filipinos have an undying love and support for beauty pageants. From stunning evening gowns to intricate national costumes, it comes as no surprise that every candidate goes all in to take home the crown. Since its formation in 1964, Binibining Pilipinas has represented our country for different international pageants like Miss Universe, showcasing that Filipino women exude beauty and excellence. In this episode of the Preview 10, we round up 10 jaw-dropping national costumes of Binibining Pilipinas in the last decade. Number 10, Catarina Rodriguez. Starting off our list with our Miss Intercontinental 2017, Catarina Rodriguez. Earning a spot in the top 10 finalists for Best National Costume, she wore a bridal-inspired regal gown created by Frances Libiran. The layered long train with the intricate baby blue details of the butterfly sleeves is the epitome of elegance. In this Filipinana look, Frances' signature laser-cut style is proof that his craftsmanship makes this costume deserving of its praise. Number 9. Elaine Bacay. In the golden anniversary of Binibining Pilipinas, Elaine Bacay wore a modern take on the classic terno which was designed by Abog Ocampo. Decorated with rice husk and sackcloth, this yellow terno mini dress represented the rice industry of her hometown, Cabanatuan, Nueva Ecija. Elaine managed to secure the Best National Costume 2013 title, further proving that he can never go wrong with a terno. Number 8. Elizabeth Clancy. Apart from winning the title of Miss Grant International 2017, Elizabeth Clancy won the Best National Costume category during Binibining Pilipinas 2011, which was also the year of the Marawi crisis. According to Elizabeth, she wanted to wear a dress that served as a reminder that there is so much beauty underneath the stigma around Mindanao that time. With its iconic pattern, we can easily recognize that the Nalak fabric where Filipino designer Gerson de Mavivas took the inspiration from, the Tibuli tribe of Mindanao. Gerson describes this sultry yet elegant dress as detail madness pertaining to his immaculate beadwork. Also, can you believe that this dress by its own weighed 10 kilos? Number 7. Samantha Poblete. Here's a definite standout from the rest. Samantha Poblete reflected her courage and uniqueness through her gender-bent Emilio Aguinaldo-inspired costume. According to designer Envar Vida of MV Couture, the costume was made only in a span of 2 weeks. Despite receiving almost 100,000 likes from netizens, this amazing look did not reach the top 10 best national costumes. But we can all agree that Samantha lived up to Cavite's moniker, Home of the Brave, as she proudly waved the Philippine flag. Number 6. Chanel Olive Thomas. In 2017, Binibining Pilipinas Supernational Chanel Olive Thomas wowed the audience with her winning costume look that's inspired by Muslim royalty. In a sea of traditional geometric design, this intricate piece created by Edwin Uy is embellished with Matsuno glass beads and a belt detail that perfectly cinches her waist. To complete her majestic look, she also wore an amber-colored sheer cape with a floral pattern, a headpiece that mimics the golden sun with connecting cylinder beads that doubles as a necklace, and matching customized gold fans. Number 5. Gabrielle Basciano. Hailing from Eastern Samar is Gabrielle Basciano. She shocked the netizens when her costume photos were released due to her use of props. Designed by Ken Batino and Jevin Salaysay, the costume was reminiscent of the Kalesa ride, a form of transportation back in 18th century Manila at the time of the Spanish occupation. Made to show off Gab's gorgeous legs, the tassels were made from scratch. Even the beauty queen herself lent a hand in making it. The golden kalesa is made out of the classic Filipino household staple, the banig, and her bodysuit is dripping in golden Swarovski crystals. It is no doubt that she lives up to her province's moniker, the City of Golden Sunrise. Number 4. Catriona Gray. Of course, it would be amiss if we didn't include Catriona Gray's costume for Binibining Pilipinas back in 2018. She bagged all 3 awards, Best in Evening Gown, Best in Swimsuit, and you guessed it, she also won Best in National Costume. Gerson de Mavivas created the outfit which was designed to make Kat look like a Maranao princess. Paired with an umbrella fashioned after the mythical Sarimanok, Kat's headpiece was actually molded in pure brass and decorated with semi-precious gems. We can all agree that she reflected her love for Mindanao's culture through her graceful presentation of the costume. Number 3. Emma Tiglao. Emma. How can we not forget about this exquisite costume? Designer Richie Sabinian named this piece Fe Esperanza Caridad, which translates to Faith, Hope and Charity, an app named for the beauty queen and her advocacy. Since Emma wanted to represent Pampanga, this Binibining Pilipinas 2019 costume was made possible with the help of Kapampangan inmates of BJMP Angeles District Jail. She truly looked like a royal queen, don't you think? Number 2. Cesarina Guyao. There were a lot of competition in this year's Binibining Pilipinas costume segment, but Cesarina Guyao's piece was a creation we can never forget. Part of the top 10 list, this one is a hidden gem. With banig as the main fabric of this piece, Cesarina also shares that the palay detail represents the hard work of our local farmers, while the crown symbolizes the devotion and high spirituality of Pampanga's patron saint, Virgen de los Remedios de Pampanga. Designed by Ferdinand Macoy Alipane and Oplong Paras, it looks like this gown is reminiscent of Thierry Mugler's The Venus Dress from his 1995 Spring and Summer collection. Number 1. Samantha Bernardo. Did someone say Mulawin? Samantha Bernardo soared new heights with this look. Securing her place as the Binibining Pilipinas Grand International 2020, this spectacular costume was designed by Patrick Isarena. Inspired by the mythical bird Ibong Adarna, he individually hand-painted thousands of feathers, embellished it with crystals, golden bells, and 10,000 wooden beads, resembling the patterns of the Palawan tribe. Fun fact, according to Patrick, its original wings design, Pamakpai, turned into fans so Samantha can do the Princesa ng Singkil hand gesture for the photoshoot, since she's actually a cultural dancer in Palawan. The costume used color gold to signify strength and power, which perfectly represents what a true queen should be. Can you imagine how many countless hours and hard work spent into a single costume? Every stitch, shape, and embellishment is proof of how much passion and talent our Filipino designers have in transforming their ideas into real masterpieces. But aside from making our jaws drop, these Binibining Pilipinas national costumes represent our culture and heritage. They are proud reminders of who we are as Filipino people. After all, the queen bears the weight of her crown for her people. Let us know in the comments below which one's your favorite.